Could you please welcome Melanie Bracewell?
You're too hot. I don't believe you got ghosted.
Oh, my... I've got a graveyard out there. Oh, I'm serious.
Wow. No. How many people have you reported missing?
Are you asking me how many men have smugly rejected me over time? Yes, a fair few. A fair few in my single days, oh, yeah.
Wow. Hey, Mel, it's lovely to see you. I haven't seen you for a few months. How did you spend your summer so far?
I have spent most of my summer at home playing Baldur's Gate 3.
Yeah, me too, I guess.
A lot of my friends are out enjoying the sunshine. I'm on my computer slaughtering goblins. So
been
my summer, yeah.
I'm not familiar with this
game. I've got a tan from the computer screen. It's really great, yeah.
Is it a good game? I've never heard of it.
It was Game of the Year last year.
Really?
Yeah, wow. And I have logged over 100 hours. It's quite sad. But then I posted that on Instagram. I was like, look how sad I am. People are like, 100 hours, that's nothing, you idiot. Yeah. Get cracking.
Well, the best way to find solidarity, I find, in spending too much time online is to post it online.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then everyone will be with you. So you've got a new show, which I love the name of this, Attack of the Melanie Bracewell. I love the definite article. It's wonderful. Should we be scared of the Melanie
you
Bracewell?
You should be very afraid. This is usually when you promote a comedy festival show, you'd know this, Sam. Mm. You don't really know what the show's about. Yeah. This year, I know what the show's about. This show is a revenge mission. Oh. This is for the guy who stole my AirPods.
What?
I have been tracking this person who stole my AirPods.
Oh, on the little thing? You can track?
On my Find My app. Right. And I have uncovered an entire mystery around it. It is there were twists and turns, and essentially you'd have to come to the show to figure out if I murdered him or not.
Is he likely? Is he likely to come to the show? Wow.
Who knows? Maybe I'll send him a mistake. Oh, who knows? Do I even know who he is? Wow. We don't know.
Oh. Yeah, I'm keeping the mystery alive. The show to find out. Oh,
well, you should check it. What if it's one of us right now? What if that was?
Oh God! I press the button, it starts beeping.
And it's
well. We found them.
Yeah. Yeah, hey, so listen, that's my show.
We had your mate, Ray O'Leary, on the show last week.
And he said mate, more sort of acquaintance. Yeah.
Okay. He was staying with you, was he not?
Yes, I have a gripe about that. So he was here and he said that he stayed with me, and I quote, for a short while, which is an oxymoron. He stayed at my house for 2 months, basically.
2 months?
Yeah. Wow.
While he was finding a place. And I kept being like, Ray, how's the house hunt looking? And he was like, I haven't downloaded that. Like, he was getting so comfortable. He was playing Glee on my Spotify over and over to the point where it was my top artist in my Spotify rap.
He told us that. He was quite thrilled.
He's ruined my life, really. So this is also a revenge plot for Ray O'Leary. Watch out.
Do you have a tracking device on you?
Yeah, of course. AirTag slipped it into his suit.
So was this? Were you home while he was? Because your show's been in Adelaide, right?
Yes, I just did my show in Adelaide. So I ran it for the first time in Adelaide, which was exciting. I had a weird interaction in Adelaide. I was checking into my hotel, and as I was walking in, I was just trying to find my phone, and there was a lady outside with a dog, and I thought, I'll make some polite conversation to this Adelaidean lady. I asked her. I was like, what's your dog's name? And she said, Brosley. And I was like, that's a nice name. And she went, you don't live here, do you? And I was like, well, no, I don't, actually. I live in Melbourne and I'm from New Zealand. She goes, yeah, everyone knows Brosley. I was like, how small is Adelaide that I made this massive faux pas that I don't recognise this dog? I'm like, I'm sorry, I haven't seen any of his films. I'm quite nervous about this. And then I asked someone from Adelaide, I'm like, do you know this dog, Brosley? And they're like, no. And I'm like, classic tall poppy syndrome.
Right.
You know, they're just trying to stamp down this famous dog.
Did you ever find out the story of Brosley?
No, I just think she was just crazy. I think she was just, you know, when you have your dog, you just think your dog's the most famous person on the block.
You think everyone's talking about Brosley, but it's not true.
Yeah.
Hey, I saw you posted a video today on your socials promoting your comedy festival show. I think we've got it here, actually. Can we have a look at this?
Yes. Should you get one of my tickets? Because I'm on four.
See, that's not bad.
Oh, yeah.
No way.
Oh, baby.
I want some honesty here. How many times did you have to do that before you got a strike?
So, this is the thing. We had the promotion 25 hours, you get $25 tickets to the show. I went, I'm taking all of my friends bowling and forcing them to watch me bowl until I get a strike. And would you believe it? First try.
Is that the answer you want to lock in there? Because I might have some other footage to show you.
Make sure you get them because I'm on. You can't have acquired this.
Okay. So that doesn't look like a strike.
Okay.
Oh, that's not bad. Oh, so close. Oh, come on.
So that's what we call in the biz just trying to stay relatable. you know, I didn't want people to be too intimidated by that first strike, so I had to humble it down.
You come down to our level.
Yeah, absolutely. You're welcome.
You can see the attack of Melody Bracewell across the country over
the
Melody Bracewell over the coming months. A link to tickets is on our website. Thanks, Mel!